Welcome back. The good thing about learning a programming language is that you don't have to memorize anything like you might have done in learning a subject in school. You only get better by practicing. So don't try to memorize these terminologies. Just make meaning of them. We will start coding soon. But let's try to understand our recipes before we start cooking. What is a programming language? We might have observed that without a pianist, a piano is nothing more than just a wooden or plastic box. Also, without a football player, a ball is nothing. Similarly, without a program, a computer, even the most powerful one, is just an object. A program makes a computer usable. Your phone can't call someone by itself. It can't watch YouTube videos by itself. The phone needs a dialer before it can make a call. The YouTube app tells the computer or your phone, hey, the user wants to open YouTube, and it obeys. So, a program is a set of instructions that tells a computer what to do. And these instructions are written by a programming language. We have to know that computers don't understand English or any other human or natural language. The only language computers understand and speak is machine language. That is binary numbers or bits, zeros and ones, on and off. So anything you ask the computer to do has to be converted to machine language. When you view a picture or watch a video on your phone, the phone receives your command as zeros and ones, but you did not input any zeros and ones. Well, there is something under the hood that translates your commands into zeros and ones so that your phone can understand, and this translator is called a programming language. Programming languages can be grouped into two, that is, low-level languages and high-level languages. For low-level languages, we have machine language and assembly language. Now, we have talked about machine language. It's level with assembly language. I'll leave that to you for you to read about it. Better still, we'll talk about it in our later courses and lessons. High-level languages are languages that are closer to human languages. High-level programming languages are languages that are closer to the human or natural languages. That is why they are termed as high-level, because Python, Java, C++, all those, the alphabet that they use, the words that they use, are just like the English alphabet. That is why we term it as high-level languages. Now, to learn a new language, whether programming or natural, one must know the alphabet, the letters, the syntax, and semantics of that language. The alphabet of a programming language that we are going to talk about, that is Python, is just alphabet of the English language plus some symbols that we might know already. The letters of Python is quite small than the letters of English language. Letters, as you already know, lexicon as dictionary. Python has reserved some words for itself. We will learn about it in later lessons. Now, the two most important things here is the syntax and then the semantics of Python or any programming language. We say that a programming language writes a program, and the program is a set of instructions that the computer obey, or the program tells the computer what to do. Now, the syntax is the rules that we must follow in order to write each instructions, and then semantics is the meaning of the instructions or the meaning of the program that we write. If any of these four elements are disobeyed, we get an error, and we'll talk about these errors in later lessons. I know you have been waiting to write your first program. The wait is over. See you in the next lesson. Let's write our first program in Python. Bye bye.